What? Whip. Oh, whip. A male voice? Yeah, that's, sorry. This one's Ster. No more Ashley. She's done for. I got jealous. How easy it was to take over my stream, so she's not alive anymore. Okay, she might be alive, but I don't know. She's not in my room. And I can't hear her voice, so she might be dead. I would have no way of knowing. Hold on, I'm clearing my throat. My throat has been like very goopy lately. And I don't know why. Do you know who is going to do the art for Kenneth? My wife on stream a day ago. Big stretches. Dude, I don't know, I've been like a tired boy. Non-stop. Just trying to make it in the world, you know? I'm considering just giving up on life and... Okay, this is only funny to me. It's... I was just thinking in my head, suicide by Genshin Impact. Like, that's the only sentence, that's the whole thought, and that's funny. That's a sad way to go. Not exactly sure what it entails. But it's definitely what you do to yourself if you play a lot of that game. It's not the way it's gonna be. I need a playlist as well. I was gonna look up like a new jazz playlist. I'd rather you see my messy room than my messy table. You'd rather make you see my hands. I'm very big. I'll show both. I got a half-eaten sandwich on my table, dude. And if anyone sees that, I'll get reported on Twitch. And I'll get banned. Coffee jazz. Okay, these are the ones that always turn into, like, heavy metal. Fucking millennial watches. By Cafe Jazz Deluxe. By Morning Coffee, I thought it said boy. I was getting excited. Like, oh, Morning Coffee Boy? That's a fucking album name. Java Joy, I can respect. Let's try this. Let's just hang out and try one of these Cafe Jazz Deluxes. Here's a completely empty map. It's got squares on it, at least. This program, I'm pretty sure, still crashes quite a bit. This program. So I'm gonna save often. And, I'm gonna figure out where things are, what the things are, who lives at the things, and make the things, and build the things, and then bring the things into map tools, and continue building the things, and I don't think I could get this done in a day. And yeah, when Dungeon Draft crashes, it sucks because it takes forever to restart. So I probably shouldn't even do it on this big of a grid. But here I am. I've never seen D&D in action, but I thought it was in your head and not an actual map. Yeah, if it's bad. If it's bad D&D. It's like any video game. Could have graphics or not have graphics. You know? Do you know? Like... I'm sick of all these pixel games, you know? Like, using pixels to depict things. I want a game that doesn't use any pixels. No monitor. Am I missing? Heartbeat Tiara, welcome. Luke Kex, dude, my throat, I'm telling you. What's in here? I'm just clearing my throat constantly. Forbidden Stream? As you can watch, Ashley. No spoilers. You've lived here for your whole life. I wish you could also set hotkeys for zooming in these programs. Born and raised. So what I know... Actually, shit, let's do this. Make that the default so we don't have to redo it. I know that a path needs to come down from the north. Go out the like bottom right. There should be like a river on the side, on the right side, wall on the left side, buildings in the middle. How easy does that sound? Is it drawing? Hello? Fucking weird ass brushes. Okay, now that's too big. Hiya. What the fuck? I didn't do that. What the my mouse isn't held down right now. Dungeon Draft. Why have I chosen you? Why did I do this? I don't know. Yeah, dude, a lot of people make it purely in map tools, which is just... You're asking for it, you know? Whoever Arcanum's main map maker is, too. Then you turn on one layer and notice that it's all been made in map tools. And then I feel bad. What makes this preferable over Photoshop with a grid layer at the top? The snap to grid building of buildings and auto applying textures within them, and you'll be able, like, this beginning part of drawing on grass, yeah, use Photoshop, but the other stuff, then you'll go, oh, okay, all right, Cat P? I don't know. 41 months, thanks. Maybe I'll figure out how to say her name in the next 40. I think we're just gonna make a big blob in the middle of town. Of dirt. The big dirt blob. Dude, that's gonna be really big. Cat pee. That's kind of what I was going for. I really hate how water is handled in Dungeon Draft. It looks really shitty. But, you know, here we are. Doing it. We live in a stomach. Hell yeah. Has it crashed already? Dungeon Draft not responding. This might be a bad idea. What I was thinking originally was to do the buildings individually on here so that I can move them later. And then I can just do the map base in Photoshop. Oh, no, I figured it out. I think that still might be a decent option, though. Because every time I edit the map throughout the campaign, because surely things will change, I'm gonna have to come back to this. And that might suck. The scale already feels kind of weird to me of where, like, how close the river is, but... There is no existing module for my completely custom setting and system, no. Am I gonna do this in here? I also had an idea of essentially, like, on the map tools map itself. Let me open map tools as an example. It'll be easier to explain things. But I think I should just build the buildings one by one. It's making a lot of sense. Loading stream. Closing program stream. Closing Steam stream. Was thinking of doing, I suppose, would be the equivalent of, hold on, loading. It doesn't matter. essentially in some places have like a path leading out of the area that when players walked down it would be a different area that would be assumed to get here. Well, you'd have to travel like up a hill and there's distance involved. So I could have like a bunch of square areas like this connected by like wooded paths, and I can even like decorate that up if anything were ever to happen along the path kind of thing. But then still you'd keep everything on one map, but still separate it and small enough that it would be loadable, but players could still go anywhere. I'm hyped for the dojo. Yeah, I'm not sure if I want the dojo in the town or like up on a hill or something. Little area looks so good. I did make this, yes. But not the assets, but the putting them here. Pudding. So yeah, like center of town could be a square like this, similar to this style. And then you can have paths going off to different areas. I think that would be fine. That's what I'm leaning towards. It would almost be like fucking, like, I don't know how new Pokemons do it, but Pokemon maps where you just, or any top-down RPG where you exit the zone and you go to the next zone. So instead of having this weird, awkward, precise, like, this is the whole road, it's just like, okay, guys, there's a long road that leads down to the river that's near town. This is the symbolic path to it over here. And then it's new area block. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I think it still would be the part of one map, unless, because what you can do is also you have the tiles that teleport people to other maps if they walk on it. So I could split them up into different maps if I wanted to, but I don't think that I want to for this one. But yeah, it cuts down on a lot of unnecessary detail. And yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna do a new file. Discard, because this is 90 by 90 tiles and I don't need that big. Let's do 60 by, I think even 60 by 60 will probably be bigger than I need for the center of town. Let's do a 50. Let's keep as little stress on young little dungeon draft as possible. Yeah, it could be a town square. I think a little bit bigger. Give me 10 more tiles to work with. The fuck? Any bigger than that, then players aren't even gonna go anywhere anyway. Just gonna be like, wow, this looks big. Where are we, DM? How's your day going? All right. I do think it would be nice if the shrine was in the middle of town. It seems to be a very heavy emphasis that everyone was kind of like, yeah, Maelstrom's all right. So then I can build like a shrine in the middle and just put houses around it. Give me grass. Give me. What does dry grass look like? Oh, like someone peed on it. Give me Dude, I love sparse grass. A lot of options. Now, I talked to Arcanum a little bit more about the interpretation of what I thought he meant when he said he was exiled. Have you used Dungeon Draft much? How highly do you recommend it? It's really good if you have a lot of the assets that work with it. And you're willing to learn its quirks because it has a lot of them and it crashes a lot. I mean, it's really not the best, but I just like the art style that goes with it. If you were doing simpler maps or of a different style, I really wouldn't recommend it. Depends. Okay, so I'm gonna lay down. I want it to be like the, just white tiles of like a big arena shrine so that you could fight in it, but also be a shrine. So everyone can come witness the Dragon Ball Z saga. And then I'll probably have to, in Photoshop, add like something on the side because I don't think this program has it. Well, most, like, I just do the base square layouts in programs like this, and then in map tools I add all the little details. Because it's a lot easier that way, and then in map tools they're all movable. I use these on the edge because they have a bolder outline. Just barely. Middle of town shrine. I probably need like pillars. I haven't used this in a while either. I'm like looking at like, wait, is there a way to change the freaking wall color? Oh, it's all the way down here. Kind of weird. And then how did you do circle walls? Without having it to be a building tool? Gee whiz. I don't think that's a thing. And then it's always gonna connect all of that. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Yeah, so this is why we lay down the base and just do the rest in map tools. I'm thinking what in map tools I would use to represent pillar. Go on a different layer. I've never fucked with layers on this either. What? What? Yeah, okay, never mind. I have not fucked with layers on here for good reason. What? I can't even go back to the other one? You think this is the best part of the program? Thank you. I don't even know what just happened. Like, how do I just go back? Undo? Nope. Oh god. Yeah, so what, drawing on this, does that make it visible on the other layer? I don't know why it would. What's the point of this? What the fuck's the point of that? Multiple floors for who? Are you playing your session inside of the fucking dungeon draft tool? I guess. Multi-layer dungeons? Yeah, just open up the program again and make the fucking second floor in a different map. Whatever. It's your funeral, buddy. My funeral? What? I think the buildings are gonna have similar base stone. Just making a few of these around. Probably have the middle open and the bottom open so you can have a road go through. Probably gonna end up editing this shit anyway. How many tiles is this away? 1, 2, 3, 4. I think that's one off. Also, doing this, I kind of also need to figure out how big the town is anyway and how many people actually live here. I think even if I filled this whole thing up, like, that would be enough. Good enough for me. Shape. Weird shape? What's the weird shape building? Ah. I do need a big, like, tavern shape building, probably. I forgot how to delete the floors I've even made. Delete. The no hotkey delete. And then you go back to your fucking same brush and you have to remember what color you used because it resets it, right? I wouldn't recommend Dungeon Draft. I have no idea. Like, how am I supposed to know? I used tiled a bit for um I don't know. I didn't have any tile sets that I liked to use in Tiled. Oh, it does. Wait, what? It does have a color dropper, but how the... Using that is quite weird. Oh, yeah, yeah. I made one map and tiled one time that I think might still be in my map tools. But it's just very cartoony, the tile set that I had. Which I don't want to do. Yeah, it looks like Pokemon. It does. It does. Like, I need to do one really simple thing right now, which is erase the edge of this, and I'm just, like, dreading doing it. That's... Because now we get to come back, have to fucking... Last time I used this program, when I was making maps, I enjoyed it a lot. Okay, now let's like find the fucking color again. I was pretty sure you could save, or it would... Don't know, ma'am. You can import textures. But it's really weird the way that it does. And you have to like load the textures when the map file is loaded for the first time. And then it loads them all individually and takes a long ass time per each one. Oh, I'll be right back to it. It's like already 80 degrees in here because I started my stream. Ugh, I almost died. I saw my wife ate two apples today. So the whole hallway smells like her ass. Not good. Three? Oh my, like, why? Just cut it out. Usually I just used RPG Maker to make maps. But they look kind of cartoony as well, so the same reason I didn't want to use that. There's a very limited amount. Like, I can't make pixel art, so I can't create assets for it. For this, I could actually make things for it. And be able to match styles of other packs. Here, I'm just gonna connect all this because these are just foundations. It doesn't matter. Building shape can be different. What the fuck? Oh, I was on edit or whatever. Thinking the style of buildings, if they would even have wood floors or... Probably have wood floors. Smart wood. Would they? I don't think they would, on second thought. Did that just not use the floor I selected? For no fucking reason? Because it's used, the tile from before is above the newest one placed? Yeah, I think this was a bad idea. Huh. I'm thinking I do what I originally said I was gonna do. I like dungeon draft as long as I make the individual buildings in here and none of the ground. And then just cut them out as like transparent PNGs. The ones you placed are above the floor layer? Why? I have two layers. One of them is nothing. One of them is this one that they're on.
Nice work. Here's the pay.
Apparently I have more than two layers. But you can't choose what layer this floor is up from the building tool! So you'd have to go to... Not a single fucking thing in this program makes any sense. Okay, so there is no way to make this floor on a different layer above the foundation that I made prior to putting this down, which just in the order of operations would make sense that this would go on top. Okay. We're off to a good start. This is going to be a progress stream. What other program could I do this in? How did I do it on this map? Yeah, see, on this, every building is separate. And then these grass tiles are even just, I just put them down in map tools. And that's easier. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna make each individual building. Then place them down on textured grounds. Which is probably going to cause its own problems. Hey, Ster, you can do this and this and this and this and that'll fix it. Yeah, but that won't fix having to do that forever from this point forward if I chose to make the maps this way and tried to make all my maps look the same. Like, 3 sessions in worth of creating maps, I'd just be mentally done. Honestly, too. I'm thinking if I could just make this part of the town. If the style, like, I don't really want these kind of tiled roofs, and these are a little more modern than I would like for random village. I'm quite organized. New approach. Precious. Not precious to me. Too green. It's a little too green. That's a little weird too. Kind of weird. Yeah, map tools can do anything with an asterisk next to it. Even taxes? Yeah. You can create tables and map tools and do your taxes in it. And I've been streaming for like 50 minutes. I have a square. Thought this would be really simple. I always think that. I think I'm gonna do one floor buildings. Wonderful. It is wonderful, isn't it? It's kind of fucked up that really all I use this program for is... Yeah, never mind. Forget the whole thought. Jazz vibes. Jazz and relax. Everything's great. Everyone's happy. Everyone's having a good time. Just make some simple things. Just keep it simple. This is going to be the very perfectly square tavern that I'm going to have to mix up the shape of. But I'm gonna hate every step of mixing up the shape because then I need to edit the points of already placed things. How do I just delete this whole thing? Okay. Okay, no, we're good. Everything's happy. Everything and everyone is happy. Everyone's a little happy. What a nice patio. I forget how you fill weird shapes with floor like this. But that's fine, because the program has already forgotten the color that I selected for them. I swear you could, like, make a copy, so it would never do that. This way. You can turn off the grid how? I'm looking everywhere for grid snapping. I don't. That's where I would put it. That's also where I would put it. And I can't. Why can't? The way that I design maps is I'm going to completely walk myself into corners with this program. Like, that's not gonna work either, because now there's this wall underneath that wall, and just undoing, like, a fucking simple shape is like pulling teeth. So now if I put a door on the front here, there's two walls there, and then one of the walls isn't gonna have a door on it, and it's gonna look weird, right? I just want to remove the one wall, but I can't get under the first wall that's already... Got it. That's it. It's gone. It's gone. Old man has an aneurysm live on stream. Now I'm just trying to make a new wall, but it's like stuck on selecting this old wall, and I don't want to fucking edit points. It's like everything technically makes sense, and it's always your fault, and everyone in chat who knows how it works is like, well, you should have just... But like, it shouldn't have been made that way. Let me just fucking pick the color of the floor again. The shingles? What shingles? my own map maker tool too? No way. This building is huge. If it's all first floor though, then it's gonna need to be. But if, I think this would be the only two-story building. I mean, this is what I get for starting the stream by saying I wouldn't recommend this program. And yet here I was. Yeah, this is too big. I'm just afraid to edit it. I'm scared. You see me clicking it to move it, but instead it's making like additional points under the point. The no, I'm moving you. Bam. Dead to me. You guys out here fucking counting my squares? You guys better not be out here counting my fucking squares. Am I even... Okay, I can do that for pillars. Okay. Y'all better go fucking to my fantasy world of madness and tell the architect that he was crazy when he built the building and did it wrong. And he'll take your criticism and give you some nodders. Yeah. It doesn't look like anything to me. It's kind of fucking crazy. In a good way. Drunk and mad and... I would actually prefer... if this bar... like, everything about it didn't make sense. And everyone in town thinks it does. So when, like, merchants come by and they're like, oh, wait. What? Like, why is there one support pillar here? No, that's, it needs to be way more off-center than that. Like... Why? Why is that there?
Leaky roof. So we built a pillar.
Okay. Here, let's put a closet right here. That's your front entryway closet. See, like, this is all I need too. And then just some doors. It fucking crashed, dude. It just fucking closed itself. I had that square so perfect too. I know the whole thing's gone. I didn't save. I'd saved a million times for the previous one, but I thought the really small scale square map would have been good. Problem streaming Dungeon Draft before? Meh. Really setting myself up for some success today. Even smaller map. We have the plan. Oh, look how tiny this is. Okay, that's a little tiny. I don't think I'd go bigger, but what if? Like, what if? Check it out. Check it out. Check it out. We're gonna do this so fast. You guys are gonna be blown away by how effective I am. Okay, save. Losing it! Alright, check this out. Check this out. Check this out. Okay. Alright, everyone with me so far? Save. Edit points. Little bit of a off-centered front up here. Little bit of a nook in the back. Look how quick he is now. He's getting it. He's fucking getting it. Yeah, I think they would build it like that. Okay, looks good. That looks like good design to me. Alright, let's get this wall tool. Let's get this wall to save. Bar is gonna be here. Opening for the bar, then like stairs going up right here. Big stairs going up. Double stairs for the fucking drunkies. All the kitchen back here. Storage maybe. Probably need a back entrance back here. Room for a door. Random pillar save. Random pillar. Random pillar. Random pillar. Random pillar. Random pillar. Oh, he's fucking doing. Oh, save. Hasn't crashed yet. This corner back here. Pooper? Is this the N2? The first one crashed, Ashley. This is the only thing we've done so far in 50... An hour. An hour and 5 minutes. This is the only thing. This is gonna be the inn. Which is, like, gathering place. I think the town might be a little bit bigger than I originally expected. Never mind, go get it. I like your thought, Pickle. One slanted wall. I do like the way you think. I'm gonna slant this wall for no reason. Just a little bit. Alright. Then if, here's the dilemma. Like, let's say, gameplay scenario. The session's been going on for a while, and the group builds up the town, and they say, you know what? That wall is slanted. Let's fix it. I have to come back in here and do that. Which would be fine in any other program, but I need to, like, save each of these maps, like, named very properly and make sure I can come back and adjust the wall in here. No, I've been saving constantly, Sultan. Don't even at me, bro. Okay, wall. Pooper? See, they're gonna have outhouses, so it's not gonna be an indoor pooper. So what back room would you need? The person who lives here, maybe? Like, runs the bar? Gets a tiny ass little room. The backroom opium den. Yeah, you always do need those, but not here. I think what I'm gonna do is, have it be connected back here, have the stairs go up. The slanted wall is driving me nuts. I want to change it so bad. Perfect. I'm gonna have that be like who lives here, their room is connected to the bar. Have a door separating it back here. Hey! Hey, Highlander. Welcome. Broccoli Burt, 25 bits. The Shroom 666, 100 bits. I like the stream. And Epic Assman right now watching your D&D campaigns with Arcadum to keep me company. Cool. NYX Sharon. Excited for the first session in 3 years? Yeah, 3 years will be good. Library? Don't even start with that shit. I don't want to hear it, man. Crash? Oh, it didn't crash. Save. Doors. Thinking if they have stone or wood, or... Windows are really annoying in map tools when you use line of sight. When, like, people can't walk through the doors, but they can walk through the windows. It's just the way it is. I think this is all that I need, other than doors. What if there's a door right here? Go for it. Because this is going to be blocked by bar. Yeah, okay. I mean, that even makes sense, but also, it's just a little bit obnoxious. Just a, like, just a tinge. Door on the slanted wall. Nah, I like it. I like it in this side. Balances. Okay, door right there. Save. This is all I need. I'm good. Building done. All of the, like, the objects, everything else, rugs, anything you could think of, lights, people, action, added in map tools. So I'm going to save this. Save as, I'm going to make a whole new folder. Like, you guys have no idea how organized I'm going to be. I accidentally named it Myriad Mapos. It's staying that way forever. Named it? Am I going to use the lighting? It becomes a little bit of a pain when you're doing it building by building, but the lighting always looks nice. So probably. Probably? Maybe? RTX enabled? Yeah, I'm gonna enable RTX on this shit. I don't know, that kinda looks weird with the pillars. I'm not sure if it looks good or weird. I think it looks weird. Can't you make them ignore the lighting? Like, objects I know have that? I don't know if walls can have that. Yes, it's really just that they are very thin. So what I should do is delete them and just make bigger ones. Oh my god, that's how you do that. Okay. Wait up. Program have a copy for this? It should. I'm gonna smack myself if it doesn't. Excellent, Pillar Milord, thank you. How do I copy you? Without just adding random points. What specific tool do I need active? Apparently not the selection one. Apparently not that. It has a copy grayed out option up here. So not that one. I don't know what I'm pasting. Apparently something, because it was doing something. All right, we'll just try our best. Best isn't good enough. Oh my god, our best is not good enough. Now, I was doing Control-C the whole time, chat. I'm doing what you would probably do if this were any other program. But so the highlight isn't even highlighting it. The copy is just fucking grayed out for everything. You right-clicked it. I've
I've done everything. God, there's no way I'm gonna like make. Players in the object tool. I don't want to use the object tool. I don't wanna. I don't wanna. They're all weird looking. I don't wanna. I'm like such a baby. Yeah, I don't, like, nothing looks right. Just tell me when you figure out how to copy something by selecting it and pressing copy. That's what I want. I don't want explanations on other ways I could do it. I want to be able to copy. These are gonna look a little weird. Because the way I did the previous ones, they at least had light bleed out into the area. I've saved. Isn't there also a, like, I don't think I should fuck with color. You can just turn shadows off, but then it goes outside the walls. This looks like a mess. Is there not followage on here? If you click your name, it tells you how long you've been following on every channel on Twitch. So, my moderators thought it was unnecessary to have a followage command, or a follow age if you want to say it that way, because it's a built-in feature to the website. I think I'm just gonna do like normal ass lights after all of that. I'm gonna cut out the outside of the building anyway. Meh. Yeah, I am. Just makes the ground look a little bit nicer. Okay, here's step two. Save. Export. With grid off. Yeah, it looks better with lighting. Camera filter, make it. Ah!
64 pixels per pinch. And go. Now, we open Photoshop. No. Okay, and then we cut it out. Do a nice little cutout. Every single map, multiple times. No, it's a good thing this jazz is grounding me. Though, actually, as we previously determined, I usually am crazier when jazz is on. I don't know, it brings out the psycho. Am I seeing something? I think I'm going crazy. I think I'm seeing something. Could I not make these maps on the layers that have nothing on them so I wouldn't have to do this? Because then they could export as PNGs. Are we getting smarter? Are we discovering secrets? Ancient texts, even? Might be possible. I'll try it next one. Be wild if you couldn't. Well, then you haven't been watching if you think that's wild. I feel like the least wild thing to happen. The ancient technology of PNGs, dude. How do they work? Is this jazz still? Does this count as jazz? Not my coffee shop. File. Save as. One second while I find my directory. One square base halfway done. I never made the door to the back. Bam.
Door. Got him. Okay. Okay. Hold. Hold. Dude, that's crazy. I like put this one in second and it went on top of the other thing on the same layer. It's blowing my fucking mind right now. How did it know? There's no way. Line it up. That's how we had it. Yeah, everything seems like it's matching well enough. Meow. I am the jazz man. Sorry, I made that song. I can't listen to my own voice. Okay, now here's the part where you hope no one notices that this one pixel on this wall is fucking showing when there's something behind it. You won't be able to tell. No one knows, chat. Okay. Okay. And then you come in. And then you start giving the people some objects. People like objects, right? Hold up. How did I do this on this other one? I see. I'm seeing. All right. It's an object. One of them. Let's get some fucking barrels back here, dude. This is gonna be tight. Get some more barrels back here. I like this barrel better. You're out, barrel. Barrel, dude. Oh my god, map tools can copy and paste? This is insane. I have never seen this functionality in a program to date. The very stylish... I hate how map tools drags these actually when they're off axis. Dude, bar counter? Bar counter? Definitely not slanted wall. Give this guy a fucking bed. Let me double check what. Where I am. Okay. Like my whole screen is captured. You're all in here. You're all in here. Okay, this guy who runs the tavern actually probably has like 40 children, right? He would have to have 40 children. He's drunk all the time. He doesn't know any better. So one bedroom isn't gonna cut it. He'll have like the house next door too. Well, then why would he sleep in here? It's not making sense. Imagine we had to go back and edit this map. Not gonna happen. Yeah, just make the kids sleep in the cellar. I have stairs, right? I don't know if I actually have stairs that just go up and down. That looks like a stairs. Okay, fuck you. Why are the stairs up an L? How come they can't match? I don't know. Good question. Good question, streamer. Here's what we're gonna have to do. We're gonna have to find like a floor tile here to distinctionize the differences. I'm losing it. I've barely been streaming. I'm fucking losing it. It's not a bowl. That's a chair. I don't think I would have a lower. I have to maybe make this myself later. Because otherwise, anything that I would have that's a texture for what I'm looking for would be very big. Now, you know what I need? I can maybe even use this. Want to be clear that one that makes it worse. That's good enough. Is it? I come into the tavern. I'm the player. What's that? Those are two stairs going down. But the right of the room is different than the left of the room. I'll draw something later. Which one of the stairs around? I think it'll look weird. or... That kind of fucking works. All right, okay. Okay. Finally did it, thank God. It changes the stair dynamic in a way that I don't appreciate, all right? And it makes a whole line down here. It's not, you think you're like so proud of yourself. It's not an elegant solution either. Everyone's so freaking proud of themselves though. A streamer couldn't think of this. Streamer's dumb. And you know what, maybe I am. Do I want these kinds of tables? No, I don't want these kinds of tables. Do I want these kinds of tables? Oh, that's a wide peepo. I swear I have wide tables like that though. Snap, I made this. Give these guys a hearth. That's how it's pronounced. Hearth. Nice song, my lord. Thank you. All right, here's where the heart goes. All right. No, maybe we don't put a heart. Home is where the heart is? Nah, we don't put the heart. Here, eat your ham shanks, idiots. Give back my heart? Nope. Nope. The lazy bartender chair. I'm down. Everyone needs a lazy bartender chair. I want a shelf that doesn't have books on it. Not a bookshelf. Why are they always bookshelves, you know? Where do these people get off? That's not a shelf. That's not what shelves look like. The fuck? Surely there's just a square. Two-hour drawing shelves? I already did that. For the skeleton ones. I saw a few, but I wanted them more vertical. You know? Streamer picks out shelves for his room. Fucking bench. Same thing. What's the difference? Copy. I'm jazzing. What the fuck? My sub expired? Yeah, shit happens, man. Get wrecked. Give me the boxes. That would actually be a better shelf. Maybe. We go with it. We do things, no one asks questions, everyone wins. Hey DM, is that a shelf? If I could reach through the internet. Try and ask me another question. I, like, absolutely need to make more variation on tables. Especially long ones. Like, that's it. This building is still too big. I am gonna use this super long one. With potatoes, not this. This isn't, no. No. Nice window. Very cool. Great stuff. I can't make it not slant it. Doesn't adjust that precisely. Candles. This wall isn't slanted. I don't know what you're talking about. These pillars are all even. Don't know what you're talking about. Every single one of them. Middle of the room shelf. Oh, we go down to the tavern. They have the best chairs in town. Best chairs in town. The only chairs in town, that's why we come here. And they're so spaced out so you don't have to sit next to, like, someone you hate.
which is probably everyone. Hoshi the Exile. He calls himself an... He's just trying to sound cool. He just got left here on a class trip. That's all. What a shame they practice witchcraft. Yeah, this is like you come to the town and you don't realize it's fucked up yet, and you come into the normal tavern and everyone's nice to you up until they have to do one of their weird cult town rituals at night. And you're like, okay. Kind of weird. Which I need to come up with. I still don't want this room to be a bedroom anymore. It's probably fine. We missed Amaring? Yeah. I need to come up with... Absolutely need to figure out a funeral ceremony. I think I have one, but it's not that weird. I would like things to be weirder. But yeah, this is this is the front. Let's put some flowers in here. Oh, you're certainly welcome here. We're all very inviting. Just sleep downstairs. We'll see you in the morning. Yeah, yep. Are there ailments in your setting? No, everyone's perfectly healthy all and like happy all the time. It's weird. Let's center these. These look like doors, but they're not. Alignments? I'm beginning to think I have like a real problem. I do that a lot. I don't know, like, am I assuming it's gonna be just someone saying the wrong thing? Or am I dyslexic? Because I swear that said ailments, and I look back and it's like, there was no G there. How do you edit comments on Twitch? There's no alignments. Either. There's no alignments. Alignments are bullshit and irrelevant. Oh yeah, I had like the front closet here, and it's not there anymore. Nothing is good or bad, but thinking makes it so. That's fucking Shakespeare. Streamers fucking quoting Shakespeare. You leave your keys at the door here for the sex party? Now this really does need to be like, we occasionally need merchants and tourists. I gotta enunciate my words. The first impression. Oh, flowers! How nice!
That's relatively authentic? People washing their hands in the backwoods village? Ashley, you gonna wash your hands? How about the fucking pot you spit in? That's what I'm talking about. Let's hit him with a quick save. Map Tools doesn't really crash, generally speaking, but when it do, it auto-saves. Anyway, so it really doesn't matter. Finger was in my nose when you said that. Yo, I could bump it to this music, you know what I'm saying? Like bumping, you guys. I know what sex is. Whew. All right.
Let's sit around this here earth and talk about our woes. So who else here is sad, miserable, and has nothing to live for? God damn it, send her the fucking chairs, heathens. That's more like it. Where's my rugs?
I probably passed them. I definitely passed them. Rug. Type in the search, I forget what they're called. Haven't done this in a while. Have I passed them again? Are they in here? Am I crazy? How many times has chat seen them? I had a whole bunch. They should... I'm looking. About to just use one of these, like, I don't... That's like a nice poop colored rug. I should have a bunch though. I've got bear skins. They might be in like another folder? At a lounging spot for snacks. There's one snake in the whole fucking town. He can eat my ass. 2 days ago, I posted in the Discord, hey, so the snake would have been in the town for 10 years. Would any of you guys give it like housing? Crickets. I'm either blind or it's somewhere else. But I need them. No, I'm just gonna keep using these disgusting placemat thingies. They fit.
Ah, my balls!
Big adjustments being made. All right, this is good enough. I can make an upstairs, but I can do it later. Time to make more squares. I reckon. I also want to focus on the center of this area, the center of town. Man, really, if I make every map like this, this is gonna take so long. I need to figure something else out. Wow, it just fits. Oh, this one's... This map is bright. I agree. Some nice little, you know, little grass. It's not what I came here looking for, though. Where's my little dirt? I know I've got them. Yo, monkey, what? It's not boat. Oh, I really do have a whole folder called rug. I didn't remember doing that. When you're too organized for your own goddamn good. I think I just don't have the dirt thing I'm looking for. I would need to actually have a dirt texture. Oh, duh, they're right here. That's what I want. Dirt. 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 Okay, I'm gonna move on. But I need to figure out what's in the middle of town. I might be able to just do that in here as well. Like, what if I used something like this? For the center. It's kind of big. I don't want to stretch it very much. It is quite large though. It looks small, but it's really not. I'm worried that it's annoying to keep clicking on everything. I'm worried that that's gonna read as like walls when I want them to be stairs. So then I would have to make stairs myself that look like this. I think it's clear enough. Whoop. Maybe not. Nah. I think this looks all right. Like half walls. Thinking maybe these would make it more clear. Or does that make it less clear? What if I did more like that so it borders it? I think that definitely makes them look like walls. Later. Yep. That's what I need, like some grass popping up in front of it. Would help a lot. Does it? I gotta think too, because this needs to, it needs to be like, I don't know that I actually want this in the center of town. Yeah, I'm gonna put this somewhere else. It's very difficult to make this be a shrine and also be centered around everything, because then I would want this to be the front of it and then like an actual shrine in the backside. I'm just gonna move the whole thing and do it later somewhere else. Later. Town hall, this is it. Is it? We'll sip a little glass of wine. I'll gaze into your eyes divine. I'll feel the touch of your lips pressing. I know, screw them. Well, or something would be good. Whisper low. Just when it's time to go. Sherry, I love you so. See, once you get down any jazz playlist enough, it's just... There was no one singing before. I think this is rant. Yeah, this is not even part of the playlist. You can lock objects, right? Right. Somehow. I know it's on here. I know it should be here. Because I've done it before. And yet, I don't know. Make another building before I do center. I think a generic house. Saving takes like a full minute and really fucks up your workflow in MapTools. MapTools doesn't crash and it auto saves like every 5 minutes. It's a reliable program. Shockingly to be able to call MapTools reliable. Well, the comparison is dungeon drafts though, so. Inbox Prime Sub, sorry, missed a whole bunch. Missed two, but they were a long time ago. Dr. Nylex as well, thanks for the sub. I'm nodding. Normal person house. Well, crashes used to be a lot more common in MapTools, but I have like panicked or safety saved thousands of times over the course of making all the Myriad stuff in MapTools and it has never crashed. Back in the day, different story. I don't want to make them just like a square, but that is how they would be. I don't even think they would have like a door poking out. Ideally normie house. I was gonna say put like farmland in their backyard, but I guess it would be more of a collective farm area. This is quite big for a normie house. How many kids these guys have? Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right. Bajillion kid beds in here. Gotta have a bajillion kid beds. Well, I'm thinking of all the things they would need and the size and... You'd want, like... master bedroom. The masters. Really wide bed. Yeah, but when you're out here, when you're out in the woods in the creepy town, I'm pretty sure your living room and your kitchen are the same thing. So I've learned my lesson that if I move this, it changes the entire floor plan. So that was a mistake that we can't undo. Such is the way of this program. So I better be happy with what I have. But I'm not. Better off not placing doors even and just leaving openings, because then I can place the doors and map tools and it'll look a lot better. But if I wanted to put an opening here, I'd have to like delete the whole... It's better off that I do that anyway because of how it was acting. Do walls one by one. I leave like a front patio thing to lay grass over. An ice box area? Where you keep the bodies? Corners though, who cares? Oh yeah, I was gonna try and see if I could do this on the zero background layer and if I could export as PNG. That's a little late for that. It's not like I'm gonna be able to copy anything, right? No. No. Yeah, but even Victorian era farmer era is too modern for this area. It's very simple here. Dino times. I think I would do shed. If I'm doing a shed, shed would be separate. Put like a chimney in here though, which is kitchen, living room. Tons of kid beds. Adult boy bedroom. I need like a closet. Probably done. What else do you need? What else could you possibly need? Closets. Another funky wall. How does this cold room work? Aren't all of the rooms in your house cold? I live in a desert. No. Well, they don't. These people don't live where you live. I think everyone would actually have a cellar. It would make sense. And this is probably good. Probably. Well, this town is super, super old. A long time ago, someone made the foundation of it. Transmutation is very common practice for a building. It's pretty much the most common magic in the world in terms of its widespread use. So the foundations, these giant stone blocks that I've been building everything on, are just stone. Okay, you have a build on that. And then they could very easily carve out like a perfect square cellar from the stone that they transmuted. So that's the plan. Potato cellars? I'm not gonna do the actual maps for every cellar. So it's gonna just be implied. Export. No, Yeah, I totally could just do a PNG on one of the other layers. Okay, that going out the front door is gonna suck. I might as well not even. I'm just gonna do them like that. Keep it simple. Shug Knight is an aphrodisiac. Thank you. Welcome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Whoop. So I gotta remember for the next one, don't do it this way. Really? Photoshop's lagging. I'm not even doing anything unique with it. I really should get the new computer. I keep going back and forth on it. Should I? Should I? Should I not? Do I need it? This computer, not been happy with it lately. Plus the whole, everything else I don't want to explain on stream because computer problem and everyone's an expert and wants to solve it. I can't fucking drag. Yeah, I should. All I'm doing is panning on a relatively small image, and it's like, no. Not today. I also started. Well, from all the streams of me even playing really basic games like Pathfinder Kingmaker, where my webcam gets blurry and slow if I'm playing any game. No good. Like, I could make this look good, but it's driving me crazy. I don't even want to fucking mess with it. Like, more than one brush stroke. It can barely do one. What the f- here's to hoping this doesn't look like shit. How is it going to? I can tell. Though I do have two bad unoptimized programs open in Photoshop. I've been trying to render the loop that I made for the starting soon for the games, and Sony Vegas crashes pretty much every time. Even for rendering a really small snippet just to test, I've been running into so many problems. What am I doing? Where's map tools? Here, I think I should, like, do that so this isn't so bright. But that's gonna fuck up other things. That's the way that it is. So curious what happened there. There absolutely was a lock movement thing before. Yeah, the front of that kind of looks like poop. That looks like poop too. Guess you can see the cut here. It's fine. I'll add more shit over it later. The hell is it called? Duh. Add all those later, make sure they're uniform and right. Okay. Put the bookshelves in the kids' rooms. I totally have a bunk bed, don't I?